Say hello to ASEAN Food Program. Today, I would like to mention about the fast food industry and the KFC scandal. The fast food industry has been developing rapidly and has successfully penetrated the majority of the market globally, at the same time bringing about several significant changes in practice, work, and eating habits. Fast food is a mass-produced food that is prepared and served quickly. The traditional family dinner increasingly replaced. As a result, the time invested on food preparation is shortened and much more convenient with affordable price. One of the famous companies in fast food industry is KFC. KFC, known as Kentucky Fried Chicken, is an American fast food restaurant chain that specializes in fried chicken. KFC was founded by Conan Sander, an entrepreneur who began selling fried chicken from his roadside restaurant in Corbin, Kentucky during the Great Depression. KFC was one of the first American fast food chains to expand internationally, open outlet in Canada, the United Kingdom, Mexico, and are continuing growing in Asia. KFC is known for its slogan, which is finger licking good. Nobody does chicken like KFC's. And February 2013, Yum CEO David admit that the scandal has been longer lasting and more impactful. The incident that raised the worries for Chinese consumers and those who are interested in KFC products. The Chinese consumers are disbelieved after the quality of the control issued. They say that as the people become wealthier, why not we can have a safe food? Why does this issue keep happening? So when the consumer felt young, had a transparency problem, they say it wasn't just a fear, it was anger. The fallout from the antibiotics issue were immense, and Yum brand has launched a supply chain assessment program called Operation Thunder to address it. CEO David said during the company's 2013 first quarter earnings call, the company can't afford a stream of food quality problems. Yum must get to the bottom of its supply chain issue, in part because the customer response to its chicken problems was so quick and violent. Yum China division saw 41 points in operating profit in the first quarter of 2013 compared to the same. As you can see from the slide, the profit, the net income of KFC declined more than $100 million compared to the last year, the 2012. After the scandal, KFC have some strategy to regain the customer trust. First, they launched a supply chain assessment, which called Operation Thunder. Besides, they shut down and stopped using every unqualified suppliers. Last but not least, they have official apologies to all the stakeholders through the website and social media. The sincere apology of CEO is the Chinese customer anger. However, the customers still doubt in quality of KFC. On the basis of above analysis, the following are the important summarizations. KFC faced a lot of criticisms because of its unethical supplier who provides them with chickens with high antibiotics. So KFC should start working with ethical supplier and create bonding with them. Moreover, it could also start a master franchising where all the responsibilities are given to single franchise. The master franchise should be solely responsible for the operations products. Master franchising helps the brand to focus on other issues that rather than concentrating on only supply chain network. KFC has a big brand value, through it has seen a lot of crises in the past few years. The brand needs to re-establish itself again in the market to regain customers. KFC has many great advantages over its secret prices and can be predicted to be realistic for the future to bounce back to achieve customer satisfaction. This comes to an end of our program. Thank you for listening and welcome you to the next episode. Goodbye and see you again.